senior who won the Class 1 championship. Congratulations on a great run, Tyler. The first question I want to ask you is, after that 3K, getting into that 4K, you ended up sliding back into second place. What was kind of going through your head whenever you ended up getting passed by Ryan Heath there? Coming into that finish line, you were able to come and easily come out there with a very nice win.
He passed me, but I had confidence in myself. I trained so hard for this, and heart and stuff. I could trust my training, and I just dug through it and came out with a win.
And you were second place last year. What was kind of the difference this year compared to last year? Was it all the training or just coming in second place in general?
Just the training, really. I mean, the guy last year passed me with, like, he beat me by 3 seconds, passed me in the last 100 meters, and I came in with that fire. I pulled it through.
And if there's one thing you can kind of give to this West Nottoway team, who had three runners placed just inside the top 15, Riley Blay at 16th place, what is kind of the leadership that you've been able to leave behind for this West Nottoway team?
Every day we dig through and work hard. I mean, we got two freshmen that are running amazing, and then me and Duke, we've been together for how long? We work hard every day and in and out every day.
Well, once again, Tyler, congratulations on winning the Class 1 District Championship. Thank you so much.
You know who has a plan B? Motherfuckers that lose. That's a fact. All these people out there talking about, oh, well, if that doesn't work out, I'll just go back to this. Whatever the fuck this is, happens to be their miserable life they have now. Those people always lose. And I'll tell you why. There's a real easy reason to understand. Because the people who go all in, the motherfuckers who burn the ships and leave themselves no other option but success, those people are dedicating all their skills, all their resources, all their energy into producing a specific outcome. And if you're competing against someone who's going all in with every resource they have, and you're only going half in because you're half in and you're half fucking out, guess what? You're gonna lose. So you guys out there with your plan B mentality, you need to take that shit, crumple it up, set it on fucking fire, because all it's gonna get you is more of what you already have.
Rises at 5:30 in the morning so he can go for a 6-mile jog. Virgin Group founder Richard Branson wakes up at 5:45 in the morning to exercise and eat a proper breakfast. GM CEO Dan Akerson rises between 4:30 and 5 so he can talk to GE Asia. Apple CEO Tim Cook gets up at 4:30 so he can send emails and be at the gym by 5.
You talking about Tracy? No. You mean like Tracy with the ass? Tracy with the Honda? Shit. Well.